Fresh over fair to Nagali Nagazi. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today it's really, and I thought to myself, let me go exercise, do my morning routines, meditate and everything. But while exercising, the feet is if I get sharp, in fact, like inside, I wanted to vomit, I was nauseous, and I couldn't even finish my exercise. So I thought to myself, how about Kikabe? In fact, you know, Ukaba means cleansing yourself. Another way to self-healing or self-care, go gap. Whatever process you feel like is the best for you. So personally, I think it will gap right now. I'm hopefully it will feel sharp and I will be able to carry on with my exercises without feeling nauseous and feel like vomiting and all those unwanted things. So it's also good for your spirit, for your health, and for yourself in general. So I've got my essentials, Jogo tea bags, Lizenke, a big Scottish Lizenke, and a pot somewhere there. Namel. Ukapa, to cleanse yourself, other people can use milk and warm water. Others, warm water mixed with salt. Others, Jogo tea bags mixed with warm water. So I decided to go with this method. I already told you, so the tea bag galore. So yeah, have again. So basically, here's the process. Mixed that Jogo tea bag, warm water, in a metal plate, you down, then eventually it's supposed to come out, right? So now the trick is that make sure when you're downing a solution, blow them at a certain position in order so that it's going to cover it more. So rather, down the solution, start straight, when you're about to vomit, and just clean just a little bit in order for it to keep on drinking.
We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
Oh, it hurts you. Ooh. Hey. Ooh. Yo. That was a painful experience. That's my first time gigapa. So it was pain. It's painful. As you can see, in Almamina, somewhere, like, what are my feet? Then came this guy with some fun facts.
So, interesting facts. I don't know what to call it in English, right? Self-induced vomiting, right? Shouldn't become a regular thing. You can do it once in a while. So the reasoning is how the system of the body is designed is to go downwards from the throat to the stomach, to the intestine, whatever, small intestine, large intestine, everything goes downwards. You pull downwards, get food in, pull it downwards to the system, digest, consume whatever, and then out you go via the anus, right? Now, when you self-induce vomiting, you reverse the system from the stomach upwards, right? You pull upwards, so you attract everything that was in the stomach and you bring it up. So you pull the system upwards, which was never designed for it to happen unless in extreme situations where you're feeling nauseous, right? So the theory is, when you do that, the whole mucus that's lining from the throat all the way to your stomach gets pulled out as well through the process of vomiting. And bagolo ba bona ba bona ba re, Lelaeta, mucus, you've been sneezing a lot, you have a runny nose because of this thing that's been in your chest, only to find out it's right there on the throat, on the esophagus, going down to the stomach. Now, why you shouldn't do it regularly is because of when you do vomit, the stomach acid rises up and it touches the upper part of your stomach, and then that contributes to the whole thing of ulcer in the block community.
Heartburn,
yeah. the ulcer burns you, and if you do it regularly, it means every weekend you're burning off some pieces of flesh there. So even if you vomit this week, during the whole week you've burnt yourself and you're busy eating chilies and acidic cold drinks and all those stuff, and you start feeling like there's fire in your stomach and you say, I have ulcer, I have heartburn, it's because you vomit too much. So limit. You do it once in a while, just to get that feeling of heaviness, of bloatedness, just to get it out once in a while. Don't abuse it, use it.
Please subscribe, like, comment, share. See you on my next vlog. Peace.